Dipsea, 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 here I come, Wednesday morning.
What is Quad Dipsea? Before that, what is Dipsea? Dipsea is a historic trail that starts at Mill Valley and goes all the way to Simpson Beach. The trail is rugged, technical, with lots and lots of stairs. Doing the Dipsea one time gives you 7.1 miles with 2200 feet elevation gain. That's called the Dipsea. Doing the Dipsea two times gives you 14.2 miles with 4400 feet elevation gain. That's called the double Dipsea. Doing the Dipsea four times gives you 28 plus miles with 8800 feet elevation gain.
We are at the start line of Quad Dipsea.
This starts with three set of stairs.
Last set. All right, done with those steps. Ooh.
The stairs lead to a short but densely rooted trail. You don't want to trip here. The trail later leads to a wide section of asphalt and fire roads all the way to Panoramic Highway.
Yeah, we'll definitely.
Hey, Len, good to see you.
Good morning.
All right. All right. Thanks for helping out. All right. Okay, to Windy Gap.
From Windy Gap, you pass through one road crossing, multiple switchbacks, great runnable trails, all the way to mailbox.
Thanks for helping out. Thanks for helping out. Hey. Mailbox section. Alright.
Just after mailbox is a steep technical downhill, later opens to a runnable section all the way to Mirrors.
Mirrors? Water if you want it.
After crossing the creek at Mirrors is a tough technical uphill called the Dynamite. It's good to save some energy here. The next mile, Dipsea Trail and Deep Creek Fire Road crisscross each other multiple times, but you need to stay on the Dipsea Trail. This section is also called Hawksback.
It's gonna be a nice sunny day. This is my motivating and healing tree. It keeps me going. Whenever I see this, I say keep moving. That's all you need. Just keep moving.
The trail passes through a runnable section called Rainforest and then leads to a highly technical, short, steep uphill called the Cardiac.
Yeah. Final push to Cardiac. Cardiac. Thanks for all the help.
You're welcome.
All right, just left Cardiac. I just picked up the gel. I'm good with my water and electrolytes till Simpson Beach.
After you leave Cardiac is a runnable section that I call the Flats. The Flats lead to a runnable downhill called the Redwoods.
I just saved myself from a fall. Concentrate, concentrate. Hey, good to see you. Look at the pack, awesome. This is my best section of Dipsea.
At the end of the Redwoods is a series of technical steps called the steep ravine. You don't want to trip here.
Good work.
Good work, man.
Looking good?
Good job.
After you cross the bridge is a short but steep uphill called the Insult Hill.
Here.
I would walk here.
The last
here.
Time I met was a Quicksilver 50K. He's a pro runner, run Western States multiple times. Great inspiration for all of us. Good job, guys.
The top of the Insult Hill is all downhill to the beach with great views of Cincinnati.
Good job, you guys. Hey, Anil! Woohoo! Good, all right. Awesome pack here, looking good, folks. Awesome! Woohoo! Here comes Rancho King, Mission Ding Ding. Hey, Stalin! Looking good, man. Hey, Karthik! Woohoo! Always, right? Right.
Good job.
Thank you, folks.
Oh.
Oh.
Good job.
Thanks for coming out. Woohoo! One Dipsea done. For all the help.
You're very welcome. You're looking good, man. Nice job.
All right. Thank you.
Stinson Beach to Cardiac is all uphill. This is a tough one. If you break it into segments, you have runnable section till the top of Insult Hill. Take it easy on the Insult Hill downhill. Take it easy on the steep ravine steps. You have runnable section of Red Bull trails, and it's all flats till you reach Cardiac.
A little behind on my pace, I need to catch up.
As soon as you leave Cardiac, it's a steep technical downhill section. I would be extra cautious here not to trip. Later, it's all the way downhill, passing through rainforest, hogsback, dynamite, all the way to Miros.
Background music, Varaharupam. Woo! Woo! I'm about to dip this a second time. Just got saved.
From Mirwoods to mailbox section is steep, technical uphill. I would save my energy here.
There goes the finisher, first place. Haven't finished but double, he's on his quad. Awesome.
After leaving mailbox are runnable sections to make up my pace here through the road crossing all the way to Windy Gap. Once you pass Windy Gap, it's just a mile to turn around, passing through the downhill asphalt, short rooted trail, and three steps of steps.
Gallop, gallop, gallop. Just leaving the aid station, filled up my water, electrolytes, two waffles and some fruits. Alright, let's get some energy for this uphill. Alright, thank you everyone. Thank you. Thank you folks! On my third Dipsea. Never gets easy. I finished my third Dipsea. I'm gonna make it.
And I did make it. I finished the race and I was DLF, the dead last finisher for the second time of the Quad Dipsea. I was glad I was able to finish it. I would like to thank a lot of people. First, I would like to thank my race director for giving me the extra time to finish my race. I would like to thank the volunteers, especially the sweeper, who were patient with me all the way till Cardiac. And a special thanks to Sam and Mandy, who are my trail angels. when I didn't have my headlamp from Windy Gap all the way to finish, they were there with me, who ran with me, motivated, cheered me with the light from their phone. A special thanks to Sam and Mandy. I'd like to thank my folks at Shades Group, Pradeep Pise, Stalin, Anil, who always motivated me on the trail, and to my special buddy, Karthik Raju, who we all trained together and is always there for me on the race, at the end of the race. Thank you for watching this video. Thank you, everyone. Thank you, Dipsea, for the lovely trail and my fun time at Dipsea.